Hello, my name is Wilke Verberg. I'm a researcher at Radboud University in the Netherlands, and I'm interested in how animals obtain oxygen underwater and how this challenge of breathing underwater changes as animals grow. So if animals do not obtain enough oxygen, they suffocate. However, at the same time, oxygen can be poisonous and having too much oxygen can be toxic. Therefore, animals have to balance the risks of suffocation and poisoning, and this requires animals to match their oxygen uptake to their oxygen requirements. And so how does this balancing act change as animals grow? One of the key things that changes is the surface area to volume ratio. Small objects generally have a small surface area compared to large objects. And this is because volume increases more than surface area with increasing size. Volume increases cubically, whereas surface area increases only quadratically. Hence, large objects have a smaller surface area relative to the volume. This principle explains why larger animals have relatively smaller respiratory surfaces with which to take up oxygen. So in growing animals, the increase in respiratory surfaces does not keep pace with the increase in mass of tissue that actually demands the oxygen. This means that the excess capacity for oxygen uptake is smaller in larger animals, and hence they have less energy available to fuel their activity, their growth, and their reproduction. And this suggests that small animals are actually better off. They should have more excess capacity. But there is a catch, and this has to do with the effects of viscosity. Water is viscous, like honey, but a bit less so. And especially small animals are affected by this viscosity. So to illustrate that, imagine water fleas swimming in water, and they experience more or less the same viscosity as if I was swimming in honey, which would require a lot of honey, obviously. But the effect of viscosity is also that it creates a thin layer of water that clings to the respiratory surfaces. And this thin layer of water is called the boundary layer, and it impedes the diffusion of oxygen, and it also can become depleted of oxygen. So animals really need to refresh this boundary layer, and to do that, they have to move water across the respiratory surfaces. And that's especially easy for larger animals, but progressively more difficult for smaller animals. So moving dense viscous water takes a lot of effort, especially since large quantities of water need to be moved. And this is because water contains about 20 to 30 times less oxygen than air. And this is also what makes breathing underwater so much of a challenge. For example, in fish, the mere act of breathing takes about 10 times more energy than it does in us humans. The high costs of breathing is also the reason why many aquatic animals still use cutaneous breathing, even when they are large and when they have gills. For example, resting adult fish, cutaneous breathing may amount up to a third of the total oxygen uptake. So, in short, water breeders expend great efforts to move the dense viscous water, and they rely on cutaneous breathing. And those two factors combined make it very difficult for them to regulate their oxygen uptake. So as a result, when the oxygen levels in the water change, they get into difficulties in balancing the risks of suffocation and the risks of poisoning that I talked about earlier. And especially small animals have a very low capacity to regulate oxygen uptake, as they rely especially on cutaneous oxygen uptake, and because they face this problem of viscosity in refreshing their boundary layers. In contrast, large animals can more easily increase ventilation rates and hence overcome the difficulties with differences in environmental oxygen availability. So in conclusion, the challenge of breathing underwater changes as animals grow. Small animals face this problem of viscosity, preventing them from maximizing their oxygen uptake, while larger animals have a lower capacity for oxygen uptake because they have relatively small surface areas to respire across. And that's why this breathing is so interesting, as it changes from small to large animals. So thank you for listening. And if you want to know more, have a look at my website or check out the links listed in the description of this video. Goodbye.